Captain Boomer coming to you live from the beautiful Twin Cities area. If you get a chance to get out and see that phenomenon that Mother Nature delivered, and I believe it's still out there. I gotta go out and check that out this evening. Of which I'm speaking is the winter solstice today. And it's supposed, and the old Jupiter and Saturn are pretty much lined up. And I guess, now one news source said it happens every 400 years. Another one said it happens 800 years. There we go again. These people just can't get their shit together. All right, let's meet them halfway. 650 years. Okay, there we go. Anyway. I hope you're having a good Monday morning. We got a little snow last night. Me and the family, we went through and did that glow. With $56 a pop for a car. But, if I had a huge Suburban or something, well, babies hold 8-9 people now. I mean, then, yeah, $56, that's not bad. But for three people, I don't know. And we didn't even bother. Is it worth the money? Nah, not quite. But is it pretty cool? Yeah, it's kind of neat. It's kind of neat. So I think the whole thing took maybe a half hour. Maybe 35 minutes. But there at the end, when you're getting out there, then all the state fair sharks are there trying to sell you their garbage again, you know. So, and the line for that was longer than the line just to get into the place. So, no way, no. Number one, none of us really need to put on more pounds with Christmas right around the corner. And number two, I'm not waiting in the line for an hour in the car while the car's running, you know. Anyway. And there you go. So, go and check it out if you want. Little spendy, but at the same time, yeah, it's kind of neat. Excuse me. Anyway, background music. Hey, Bob, you're supposed to be on this, Bob. Come on. You know I need background music. Anyway, I got some kind of interesting... Oh, wait a minute. Oh, this ain't going to work. What's going on here? The old captain, I like to interject a little bit of my input here as to what's going on. Well, this is really weird. I've never had this happen before. Wow. That's really... Anyway. Maybe this thing is really starting to go. I gotta get new old Goodwill equipment. Yeah, because it's... I don't know why I can't play this well. It's kind of goofy anyway. Do I got a backup, Bob? I usually have a backup, don't I? Huh? Bob? Oh, man. Well, we can go right into this, okay? Because it is the holidays time. I was going to do 12 Days of Christmas, but I don't know. I got too lazy. Too complacent. I didn't. Anyway, but here's a little bit of Bubba Claus country Christmas album. I'm gonna play a few of these songs for you guys. I hope you enjoy them, and then we're gonna get the old captain, I got I don't even know if the story's true or not, but you know, it's one of those stories where, especially when you're dealing with the VA, I wouldn't doubt it one bit. But I'll be sharing that. It's a major kind of a screw up. I'll be sharing that with you in a little while, guys. Okay? You betcha. Right, Popeye? Where's Popeye? Where do you go?
Hey there, Alabos. Hey there, Bluto. Where's my spinach? Somebody took my spinach. Well, blow me down.
You betcha, Popeye. Are you guys ready? All right. Hope you have some fun with this one, guys. Or maybe not. Here it goes.
Here come the boss, here come the boss, through the trailer park. Oh, Dicks and Blitz and all them reindeer, best be gone by dark. Bells are ringing, all that jingling done make a pitbull bark. Bubba Claus is hauling ass through the trailer park.
Woo!
Here come Bubba Claus through the trailer park. He hit the foothold by the dumpster, passed that car on the block. Dodge and blasted, big flamingos, rusty garden chairs too. Hang your stockings on the gun rack, Bubba's coming soon.
Here come Bubba Claus, here come Bubba Claus through the trailer park.
Vixen, Blitzen, and all them reindeer best be gone by dark.
Here come Bubba Claus through the trailer park.
He's crashing through a pile of gas that's out in the yard. That old recliner on the front porch sings and catches eye. Bubba can't rest till he visits ever double wide.
Woo! Here come Bubba Claus, here come Bubba Claus through the trailer park.
A bits and blips and all them reindeer best be gone by dark.
What do you guys think, huh? Bubba Claus is hauling ass through the trailer park. Oh, yeah, gotta love that one. Oh, you betcha, there's more where that came from. True damn right. Anyway, it is Monday. Monday, the 21st, 2020. A year that we soon will be out of, thank God. And I don't know what else to say. It's just that, I'm telling you, there is, you know, the more this stuff, I listen more to this stuff with the COVID, it's almost like in a weird sort of way, we kind of want this thing to continue because there's so many different things in place that just doesn't make any sense. And here's another one that doesn't make any sense. A lot of them. Let's see if I can't find one of these, because I'm just, that ain't going to work. That ain't going to work. Come on, guys, I got lots of them, I know I do. Anyway, here we go. Maybe this one will work, guys. This one might work better. Hang on. But anyway, I don't know about you guys, but it's, here we go. It's almost like there's a pattern out there. Yeah, okay, here we go right here. The deal is, now they're saying that over, I guess, what's London or the whole country, UK is closing down or something like that, or not, travel restriction, all this stuff. But now they're saying there's a new strain of this virus out there, okay? A new strain, okay. Whether it, you know, mutated or whatever off the original. But this one's supposed to be, I heard, there again, two different place stations said two different things. One didn't say anything about what I'm going to mention, and the other one did. The one that did said it is 70, it's not any more deadly than the original one. And it as far as they know, it will respond favorably to the vaccines. But here's the kicker. They also said, as one station said, that it is 70% more transmittable. Yeah, 70% more transmittable. Yeah, that's wonderful, isn't it? And here's the other kicker. But they're allowing, now, if I heard right, and I guess Mayor Cuomo, I guess, from New York, he's really pissed, and rightfully so. Supposedly, they're letting some flights, people that want to come to the U.S., from the leaving Heathrow airport, I guess it is, in London, and they're going to be flying over here. They're letting them come here. There again, that is not really conducive as far as old Captain Boom is concerned with doing the right thing to be safe. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, that's just one little. There's so much more here. It's I just don't get it. All right. Here's another thing. Boy, I get to vent because my mind is just going all the time. In the wrong direction or backwards, granted, but nonetheless, it's churning, baby. You betcha. I got to have some more of this triple espresso stuff I got. Hang on. Okay. Here you go here. Let's talk about vaccines for a second. The vaccine itself, I guess they're saying, oh, it's wonderful. It's a miracle cure. Here's the thing. Now they see they're having problems getting enough doses in certain parts of the country. They shortchanged us. We didn't get what we wanted. All this other stuff. Yeah, well, all right. Now they're saying Moderna. Moderna does not have to be deep froze, you know, like I'm saying, like 95 below or something. I still don't get that either. So if that's a big part of the hang-up, and I'm sure it is, I'm willing to bet it's a big part of the distribution problem that they're having. So why doesn't Moderna and Pfizer get together, kind of mutual partnership? And Moderna, by the way, they claim that theirs only needs to be refrigerated, and it doesn't have, and it's whatever, I don't know. So why aren't the two getting together? We're talking about people dying here. Why aren't the two getting together and say, hey, you know, Pfizer, hey, we'll work with you and we'll share our secret with you or our concoction. So it doesn't have to be 94 below kept at. You see what I'm saying? I thought we were supposed to be all on the same page here if we all want to get through this. Yeah, anyway, I don't know. I just think it's amazing. But there again, that's capitalism at its best, I guess, or at its worst, where, hey, I'm not going to share a secret with you. Hell no, I'm not going to, I might lose some profit or some money here or something, I don't know, but we're not talking about sharing secrets for a brand new, tire here or anything, you know, we're talking about people's lives, so I don't know, I just find it amazing that they won't hook up. Here's another thing I want to share with you, kind of a funny note here. Oh yeah, it's funny, you know how much I love the VA. They do good things, but they do some screwed up things. Anyway, supposedly, you take this with a grain of salt. I don't know, like I said earlier, I don't know if it's true or not, but I wouldn't doubt it, okay? I like to look on the comedy side of it, so let's just go with that. All right, supposedly the VA is having a recall on a whole bunch of pills out there.